사람 봤어.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2,
Good afternoon, my brothers and sisters in Christ. We are here to celebrate the life of our brother Kenrick Robinson. We prepare his prayer to receive his body for burial. Please stand if you can. With faith in Jesus Christ, receive the body of our brother Kenrick for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, remember before you this day our brother Kenrick. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we will continue our course on earth, until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. The eternal God is our refuge, and on the lead are the everlasting arms. Your response should be, Holy God, Holy and Mighty, Holy Immortal One, have mercy upon us. Sorry, you have the eulogy. First hymn, Blessed Assurance, and then the eulogy.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture burst on my sight. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercies, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my
Kenrick Robinson. But here. All right. Who is Kenrick Robinson? The man, the myth, the legend. The dancing man. The sportsman. The father, the brother. Caregiver. Kenrick Robinson was also known as Uncle. And I'll get to that part before we get Uncle. He was born on the 16th of August 1935, McMead Village, Hoover, to Alfred and Rosa Robinson, where he later moved to Bank Village, Carpichima. He married on the 1st of February 1970 to his lovely wife, Claire. I can't leave out the Sandy Robinson. His children, Ricky, Clint, and Marlon, and by extension, his adopted daughter, Obika Robinson. He stood at 5 feet 10, weighed 173 pounds, but now I know he was fooling me. Attended the primary school of Hoover, RC, California, government school. He went to San Fernando Tech Institute. As he go forward into his life, he joined the Ministry of National Security, which is the fire service, in 1958. And in 1989, he retired. He went in to accomplish a lot of things. One of the things that he went on to deal with is that he was a safety officer. He went on to join the football club, which is better known as Superstar Rangers. He did he was called the medic. And other names were called. He was called Fires or Fireman, Uncle or Robbie, as we knew him. But at home, we know him as Uncle. And how we get Uncle? Well, I called somebody's name, and Obika was one of the persons more or less started off the adopted daughter. It come about by just she said Uncle, and eventually everybody else who known to the family, down to the grandchildren, calling them Uncle. Right? So it stick with him until, on this day, he always remembers the father, brother, and uncle. He got the opportunity to experience his children, grandchildren, great-grand, everybody who had the opportunity to be around him will know that he is a man. If you see him now, he might be hearing no music, and I know where he getting that music from, but he dancing. Mommy remind me today that they used to go online. I can't recall that, but they used to go and go in tent and all kind of things. So I was shocked. I didn't realize he's a man like that. So he was a person who enjoyed life. Right? He take the opportunity to experience things. While he finished the fire service, he went on to join different things, and he went on to do a lot of short courses and establish himself. He made all of us laugh. That is one of the things. Regardless of how you feel, regardless of how your day went, he'll take the time to make you laugh. During my years growing up, and growing up not in Mac Vancouver but in Edinburgh Gardens, Shogunas, once mommy had an opportunity to deal with us, myself and Clint. But once she deal with us, you know, Robbie had to put the 2 cents too. And that 2 cents could be by belt, whatever means necessary, we had to get a little touch. And you see how we turn out. A little touch ain't hurt nobody. So we have it on the right path. Once he abused me, but at the end of the day, he was on the right path. He was always making everybody feel that, hey, why are you like that? Even my wife, Denicia, they had a little, I don't know. I mean, I watching them, I see the laugh. I try to understand what they're laughing at. And back and forth, I realized they cherish a particular relationship. Just as everybody else, in his own way. My brother Ricky, who he got the opportunity to go away and see his grandson and daughter and experience them in his life. How we wanted to actually see them and talk to them. So my father lived a happy life. And we all know nobody's perfect, but he's a person whenever he get the opportunity to go somewhere with mommy. One thing always at the arm. He will knock on the door, you ready yet? Want to know if you're ready yet? He ready to go in the house. That is his castle, that he peace. When he reach home, well, you know you don't see him, right? Where he's be in the room. Now, I always wonder why a fireman is sticky rest, so I understand why. He's a man could sleep. But that'll keep him sharp too. That'll keep him fresh. And you don't take on nobody. Right? So, like basically my father and our children. He came into this world. He do what he need to do, join the service. After he left, he went on, and he always joined sports. Football was one of the things, and even cricket. Even at Edinburgh Gardens at the Savannah, he used to go and partake in the little wind ball cricket community. And the community always have activities whereby he always involved us. Even from when we were small, had a lot of community development programs and we were involved from small. He loved music, always danced, as I said before, and he celebrated his life. And that's that will be about here for, is that the celebration of his life and his accomplishments. So uncle, daddy, brother, he's in a better place, no more stress, is at peace and wanting, even when he were young in age, he always called for mommy. That is his love. Regardless of what, always want, where mother? But although when you're ready to go, you're ready yet? So, Kenrick Robinson, that is him in a nutshell. Simple person, never fuss, always ready to get people laughing, and always ready to go and enjoy life. So, this is Mr. Kenrick Robinson in a nutshell. I want to take the opportunity now to thank the neighbors of Marigold Avenue who supported us in these times. All the members of the residents of Noble Gardens, the bishop of TNT clergy and the parishioners and the diocese, St. Thomas and St. Andrews, friends, relatives, and other supporters. I thank you.
Stand, please. The Lord be with you.
And
let us pray. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us the true faith and the sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit for the ministry of the word. Psalm 23.
The quiet heart is thine. My soul he doth restore again, and me to hope doth make within the path of for his own insane. Yea, though I walk in death's dark vale, yet will I fare no ill, for thou art with me and I of me comforts thee. Our table thou hast furnished in the presence of my fault. My love thou hast anoint with oil, and my cup overflows. Goodness and mercy all thy life shall surely follow me, and God's house forevermore, my dwelling place shall be.
Now we have the second reading.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 3, beginning at verse 14. For this reason I bow my knees before you, the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that according to riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted, grounded in love. Pray that you may have power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpass knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. The Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The hymn "Great is thy faithfulness." Thank you.
changes not thy compassion, it will not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thine great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and the peace that endureth, thine own their presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to Christ, our Savior. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of Christ. Please be seated. On behalf of the St. Thomas Parish family, and the parish family of St. Andrew Coover, and my own family, we convey to the Reverend Claire Sandy Robinson and her family, children, Ricky, Marlon, Clint, and all members of the family, our deep sympathy on the passing of Kenrick. We thank God for Kenrick's life and witness, and indeed for his ultimate healing of him. The Old Testament prophet Isaiah describes God's ultimate triumph over death and pain as a festival, a feast of victory over all God's enemies. In a real sense, today we are at that feast of victory because we have a blessed hope that we'll see our brother Kenrick again. And we'll see him again at God's table, where the greatest enemy of human heart shall have no place. And all who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ will be present with him forever. So permit me to share with you this afternoon, a passage from the Gospel of John, chapter 5, verse 24. Very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes in him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. John, chapter 5, verse 24. And I guess by now you'll be wondering, why am I quoting from John when the Gospel was John 14? But let me tell you the secret. My first encounter with Kenrick, the first time I met him, after saying to me a number of things, some of I can't repeat here, but the one I can repeat, he said to me, boy, what is it about this eternal life? What is that? Tell me now, man. And he walked off, you know. And then he came back and we spoke. He said, I like you. I like you, I like what you say. And from then on, Kenrick and I had a relationship. That's why I knew him all my life. This man, I call him the secret dandy boy. He would approach you with something and he bumps you and then he moves off and he comes back. And that conversation I had with him, in my preparation, I started with the Gospel, John 14, 1-6. And then he came to me, I said, no. I had already sent out the program, so I couldn't change the Gospel. So I decided to share this with you. So I preach to you in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Eternal life is living with God forever. This verse from John's Gospel sets forth the way of salvation so very clearly. And Kenrick was inquiring about that. To me, he had a deep concern when we read it first. And he said, boy, I heard so much about you, and I want to talk to you about this thing. And I went along and we spoke. So, in fact, Christ himself starts this verse with the words, very truly. This means most assuredly. The words are to let us know that he was making a very important statement of fact. Then he said, I tell you, here Jesus is speaking to us in a very personal and intimate way. He wants us to know that these are his words, that he is the one who's speaking. He continued, anyone who hears my words and believes in him who sent me has eternal life. Note that what Jesus says, he did not say, will have eternal life. He's saying, has eternal life. Do you believe that? you believe the word of God. He didn't say that you will have it, you know. He said, you have it now. And does not come into judgment. The one who believes in the Lord Jesus Christ will be free from judgment. That is, when we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we accept Jesus Christ, and new life begins. Begins where? Begins in us. In you. In every one of you. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, and by the Spirit that lives within us, that convicts us, points us to the life that is in the Word of God. Here, we will see and face physical death. But when Christ returns, our body will be resurrected to live forever with Him. 1 Corinthians 15. Now, this old body will not be the same as the resurrected body. This new body will be free from sin, free from pain. It will not be subject to sickness, to COVID, to heart problems, to kidney problems, nor will it be subject to death. Death will be swallowed up in the victory. When the dead hears the voice of Christ, it means that they who hear have accepted Jesus. This also means that at His second coming, all the dead in Christ will rise to meet Him. God is therefore the Creator, and there is no life apart from Him. My brothers and sisters in Christ, the life we have today is a gift from God. Let us cherish it. Let us use this life to live for Christ. Jesus is life because He's eternally existent with God His Father. It is through Jesus that we have eternal life. If we want to live with God forever, we must choose Him and live our lives in accordance with His will. We must trust Him, and love our fellow men. We must be ready to meet Him every day and every stage of our life. There is a passage we read at funerals. Very often, in the midst of life, we are in debt. From whom can we seek help? Or from you, O Lord? When we repeat these words, we are saying, Lord, I am ready to meet you. I am prepared. I have lived my life. And if you call me home today, I am ready and ready, prepared to meet you. My brothers and sisters, eternal life is a person's life when lived. Is a person's life when God has spoken His yes upon it, once for all, not to be changed anymore. It is a higher quality of life. It's a higher quality of life the Savior has imparted to those who believe in it. Eternal life is a person's life lived in God, lived with God. In His bright light, God nourishes and sustains this life. He sustains it by His own life and His own examples. Eternal life is a person's life committed to the service of God and thereby to the service of neighbor. A life which is certain, a life that allows the one who chooses to live it. Eternal life is a strong, not a weak life. A joyous, not a sad life. A true, not a deceitful life. So my brothers and sisters, this afternoon I want to let us know that eternal life is a person's indestructible life because it comes from God and is sustained by God. Thus, this gift is in proper hands. Hands that are pure, hands that care, hands that are kind, hands that are loving, hands that are comforting, hands that are careful and selective, hands that put people first. Yes, it is the hands of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us that the souls of the righteous are in the hands of God. Here, God took Kenrick to Himself. Faithful and perfect. God wants us to understand that He calls us to trust Him. and therefore we must trust him. As God is near to every one of us, he's not far away and never will be far. God is good. This means that he's just, kind, loving, forgiveness, liberative, and inclusive. To receive the great comfort of God, we must know him, continue to trust him, and to wait for him. Psalm 130 verse 4 tells us, wait for the Lord, my soul waits for him. In his word is my hope. So today I say, into the hands of God we commend the soul of our brother Kendrick. And I ask Reverend Claire, Ricky, Marlon, Flint, and the entire family to take comfort in the thought of him who watches over you. You will never be alone, because the Lord is your shepherd. Thus he shall take care of all your personal and physical needs, and will continue to comfort and heal your wounds of loss and regenerate. As we continue to reflect on the gospel lesson for today and the verse from John's gospel, Jesus reminds us that he is the resurrection and the life. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and trust him. If we believe in Jesus Christ, we live the risen life now. And when we suffer loss as death of a loved one, we can take comfort because Jesus is our friend and that he will never leave us nor forsake us. So in the spirit of the text for today, I say to all of us, very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my words and believes him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from life to death. So let our lives be rooted in love for God and love for neighbor. And may each of us set our sights on a life in Christ. I share with you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Sessions we use for A. Your response is, here's Lord. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Kendrick and dry the tears of those who weep. Hear us, Lord. Hear us, Lord. You wept at the graves of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Hear us, Lord. You raised the dead to life. Raise our brother Kendrick to eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Kendrick to the joy of heaven. Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with your saints. Hear us, Lord. He was nourished the body and blood with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us, Lord.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother Kendrick. Let our faith be a consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Kendrick, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us victory over over death, and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit for the ages. now have the commendation. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saved, with your saints. Where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust we shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave will make us some. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us commend our brother Kenrick to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Kenrick, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in eternal habitation, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Sing into your hands. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Kenrick. Acknowledge, we beseech you, a sheep of your own fold. a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints. Ensure uncertain hope of resurrection to eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Kennedy, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite, and we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Kenrick and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord.
Let thy perfection shine upon him.
May he and all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord bless him and the Lord keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his light upon him and give him his peace. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Let us move forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The hymn, I am walking on my way to the Lord.
Thank you.